Today we are at St. Stephen's celebrating the Sunday of Orthodoxy, and we're hosting the Pan-Orthodox service. Bishop Maxim is the host, and we have representation from all the Orthodox churches in Southern California, not only the Serbian Orthodox churches, but all of the Orthodox churches combined today. It's a wonderful tradition when we can get all the churches together in one common service and one common community. And today we celebrate the triumph of Orthodoxy, and we'll have a procession of icons, which is significant to our church because during the ecumenical councils, the first ecumenical council when we received the authority to worship with our icons. So we'll together process around the church with the icons, and it's wonderful to have such a great turnout today. We have around six to 700 people from all over Los Angeles, not only the Serbian Orthodox community, but all the Orthodox communities, and it's our way of being a good host to all these people and to show what St. Stephen's has here for our community. I'd like to thank Father Nick for being an anchor in organizing this entire event, and the Women's Auxiliary for putting on a wonderful luncheon today, and all the churches together putting together all the food with the different women's groups around the Orthodox community. And I'd like to thank Bishop Maxim for being a wonderful host in this wonderful celebration.
Said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the town of Andrew and Peter.
I have become an idol to myself. It is an era that offers falsehood, illusion, and fantasy without transcending the antinomies of history and the limitations of Christ's hands, feet, and side. Similarly, the language of the fathers about icons, especially that of the Seventh Ecumenical Council, has to do both with seeing and beholding this vision.
In history, you can call the icon meta-historical. Nevertheless, the kingdom can only be depicted by using created means. The icon is distinct from the truth. not because it is false, delusional, or fantastic, but because it borrows its means of expression from still corruptible nature. Although its means of expression derive from fallen nature, the icon refers to inexpressible truth by encouraging our personal relation with truth. A proper icon creates true personal relationships, makes the earthly church what it is, namely,
let us again pray for our brother bishops and concelebrants, Joseph, Maxim, and Benjamin, and for our brother priests, deacons, and monastics who pray and who celebrate this divine liturgy with us, and all our brotherhood in Christ. Let us again pray for our country, the president of all civil authorities, that the Lord God may direct their actions for the good of all. Let us pray again for all the faithful who serve in our parishes, in ministries promoting the word of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and of all those who work with the Orthodox missionary activities throughout the world and in our country, bringing the teachings of our Lord to all.
Danas je prva nedelja Svetog Uskršnjeg ili časnog posta, nedelja pravoslavlja, i imali smo ovde zajedno službu sa drugim pravoslavnim crkvama u ovom sabornom hramu Svetog Stevana. Pošto je veliki broj naroda, mi smo napravili ovde jedan šator i služili kao u stara dobra vremena Staroga Zaveta, kada se u šatoru, u skini i održavala bogosluženje, a eto u Novom Zavetu i nama je šator danas poslužio na mesto crkve, pošto je veliki broj naroda, hvala Bogu, bio prisutan. Služili su episkopi, naš preosvećeni episkop dr. Maksim iz naše zapadnoameričke eparhije Srpske pravoslavne crkve, episkop Benjamin, on predstavlja Američku pravoslavnu crkvu, i arhijepiskop Gerasim, koji predstavlja Grčku pravoslavnu crkvu. Arhijepiskop Gerasim je tu došao iz San Franciska i on je i načalstvovao, odnosno vodio danas ovo bogosluženje. Kao što vidite, veliki broj naroda se okupio, više od 5-6 stotina ljudi je ovde prisutno. Iako je dan oblačan i prošlu noć padala velika kiša, ali eto, kome je srce otvoreno za prisustvo Božije, njemu ne smetaju nikakve nevremenske nepogode ili udaljenost. Dakle, danas smo pokazali naše pravoslavlje i da smo mi jedna pravoslavna crkva, iako smo podeljeni po našim nacionalnim crkvama na grčku, rusku, srpsku, američko pravoslavnu i druge. Još jedan puta neka je sretan i blagosloven ovaj dan. Evo, već se i vreme malo opet počelo da menja i vetar duva, izgleda će ponovno počne pada kiša, ali i to je Božji blagoslov, jer kiša je uvek dobro došla u ove predele Kalifornije. Neka Gospod blagoslovi sve pravoslavne narode, da održe pravoslavnu veru u ovom, u ovoj novoj zemlji, u ovom novom kontinentu Severne Amerike.